Shanti, shanti, shanti. Always identify yourself with Atma. Not the jiva. This conscious mind-body complex is made up of two things, jiva and atma, jivatma. Atma is self, pure self. Jiva is ego, one who thinks he is this body-mind complex. If you identify with your mind, you are jiva. You stay in the illusion, you stay in this world, you stay in the Maya. But let's say you identify yourself as Atma and you still have a mind. You will be free. Choice is yours. If we have desires, if we have strong likes and dislikes, if we are getting disturbed by thoughts, we still have some business with mind. Or maybe mind has some business with us. Let's say you are a seeker who wants to be free from the mind. You are not interested in any mind talk. You don't intend to have any likes or dislikes. You don't intend to have any desires. But probably you have given some work to the mind in the past with desires, with likes and dislikes. So mind is on its mission to fulfill those desires, working according to your likes and dislikes. So wait. give your attention to pure awareness. Spend whole day in awareness. Let mind do what it is doing. Acknowledge what it is doing, but don't engage. When it realizes that you are not interested, it will give away its previous tasks, whether they are fulfilled or not. But don't give any new task to mind. No new desires. No new plans or agenda. No new likes or dislikes. You are putting sincere efforts in your sadhana, in your practice, and you want results quickly, completely. You wish to be in eternal peace. You want to be what you are actually. That God principle, which is always pure. Then stay as uninvolved Atma. Uninvolved self. Accept firmly that you are pure awareness. Don't identify yourself with the mind, with the body. Body stays, body goes. It should not matter to you. You are always the same. Be full of this conviction, whatever comes. If you are 100% convinced, then your job is done. You are free. It is all about your own conviction. be convinced without any doubts that you are pure awareness. Uninvolved witness. When mind throws tantrum, a strong thought comes. Be vigilant. Now don't bow down. Now show how strong your conviction is. Stay uninvolved. Stay as an observer. How long a thought or an emotion can stay? How many strong thoughts you had in the past, which gave you sleepless nights, and now you can't even remember them. Don't worry what thought it is and about what thing it is. They are all part of this waking dream. They are not different from your dream world. Thoughts are the only fuel which continues this waking dream. And thoughts comes because of desires. Desires comes because of I thought. I thought is identifying with the body as I. And treating your mind as your mind. Trusting your mind, obeying your mind, and staying in the mind. An illusion continues. Always practice to stay detached. Detached from your mind, from your body. All unfinished tasks, all compulsions, all obsessions are only product of mind. Remember, you are uninvolved. You have come to this world to observe, to witness, and to leave. Don't bite any apple. Don't get deluded. Enjoy what comes, enjoy what goes. Don't hold on to anything in this world. Your hold is bondage. Only hold on to your pure self. Remember it. Don't expect the world to change. Don't expect people to change. You just dissolve. You who is looking for change should dissolve. Dissolve completely so no trace is left of any identity. Only awareness. This is deathless death. You will be not charged for this death. Death of your ego. If a person does suicide, ego is not killed. So there is no end of suffering. So this death is not real death. It is the death of falsehood, false belief. Belief that you are this body-mind complex. Endless desires only prove to us that we are slave of the mind. We don't know who we are. Abide in pure awareness, infinite awareness. And you will know that you are a king. You are always a king. You are the creator of what you see. The world, what you see, is projection of the mind. Exactly like you dream, created by your mind. In dream, mind creates you and others and objects. Exactly right now, mind has created you. You as an identity, others, and this whole world. You are beyond mind. You are the substrata. You are the screen on which this movie is being played. Movie of this world. You are not any emotion, feeling or thought. You are not a doer. You are not in any action. All this is done by mind body. You are only an observer. Be observer. Identify yourself as an observer. Name given to you is name given to body. Everyone in this world, including your parents, family, all identify only the body. You are the essence in the body, without any name, without any form. You as pure awareness has no family, no friends, no body, no mind. And still everything belongs to you. Everything is on the stage of this awareness, infinite awareness. It is within body and outside body. There is no place where awareness is not. Body has limitations. You are limitless. Body has requirements. Food, water, air, shelter. You have no requirements. Don't waste your time pampering this body. This body is on path of destruction, decay. It has an expiry date. Fulfill its needs, but don't get obsessed with it. Even during fulfilling its needs, don't identify with it. Be the pure awareness. This is the only difference between a sage and a person. Identification. I'll tell you a short story to reflect this point. There was an Indian sage, Ved Vyas. He had a big sumptuous meal on an occasion. And after having that big meal, he was informed that there is a big flood in the river and there were visitors who came from the other end. They could not return back. So they asked for his help, if he can do something. He said, I can't do anything, but yet I can ask God about it. And he prayed. He said if he was never hungry and never had any food, then give a way to people to cross the river. And a portion of the river dried up and people crossed to the other side. But so many of them got surprised. They thought it's a lie. They fed this sage and he said he was hungry. This is his conviction. That he is pure self. He is not the body which is hungry. Have that conviction all the time. And this conviction can only come when you are pure awareness. You remember pure awareness. You abide in it. And you have lost identification with body-mind complex. No identification with body-mind means there is no I am, no ego. No middlemen, only godliness, only bliss. You are pure presence, eternal presence. So don't act like a person. Stay as presence in this person. allow awareness to take over all functions. Allow awareness to bless this body-mind complex. Allow by surrendering your ego. Surrendering your small self. For people around you, life is a struggle. For you as presence, life is a present. It's a blessing. It's a divine gift. Perfect harmony without any resistance. Awareness is utmost clarity, impartiality. Pure silence. Eternal silence. When there is no thought, to reach this perfect stillness, start accepting whatever comes in your way. Total acceptance. Have no expectations from anyone for any reason. No surprises for you. If you can do these two things, you will be free right now. No one can make you unhappy if you have no expectations. No one can make you unhappy if you accept everything. No situation. enjoy your own bliss. Get absorbed in your own grace. Your own divinity. And spread this divine love even if you don't move, don't meet anyone. It will reach everyone. You are like sunshine, rays of pure awareness spreading around to everything, every being. You are not doing it. It just happens. Keep going deeper and deeper in your seeing. Om Shanti Shanti.